everyone, welcome to Botany Insider, and in this lecture we would be discussing a very important topic and also a very easy topic that is related to the unit of plant physiology, and that is biological clocks. So let us understand about that what biological clocks are. So biological clocks in simple word means a regulated time mannered sequence of events that is happening in our body. So we can say that biological clocks are organisms' natural timing devices that are regulating the cycle of the circadian rhythms. They are composed of specific molecules, and these molecules are majorly the proteins that interact with the cells throughout the body. Nearly every tissue and the organ of our body contains the biological clock. So we can also call as that biological clocks are the natural clocks that are operating inside our body in order to function properly depending upon the timing at which the particular clock is functioning. So let's understand about the types of biological clocks. So we have majorly three main types of biological clocks. The first one is the ultraradian, then we have the infraradian, and finally we have the circadian rhythms. Let's understand about each one of them in detail. Talking about ultraradian rhythms, so these are the biological clocks that takes less than 24 hours to get completed. The most common example is the sleep stage cycles. That is, the cycle of sleep that we operate in our body is a most common example of the ultraradian rhythm that we are talking about. As you can see in the figure, instead of going into the depth, just remember that these type of rhythms or these type of cycles are the one that takes less than 24 hours to get completed, and the most common example is the sleep stage cycles. In our sleep cycle, we mainly have the five stages, that is stage 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. In the first stage, we have 4 to 5% of the light sleep. Then in the stage 2, we have the breathing pattern and the heart rate slows. In the third stage, we have 4 to 6% of our sleep getting completed, and so on and so forth. Just remember that sleep cycle is the most common example of ultraradian rhythms, and these are the rhythms that take less than 24 hours to get completed. Talking about the next type, that is infraradian rhythms, so these are the rhythms that take usually longer than 24 hours to get completed, and the most common example of the infraradian rhythms is the menstrual cycle. So as we all know that menstrual cycle usually operate in every 28 days. So this is the most common example of the infraradian radiations. So you need not to go into the depth of how this cycle operate. Just remember that we have a menstrual cycle, the most common example of the infraradian rhythms, which takes usually longer than 24 hours to get completed. Then we have the circadian rhythms, which is the most important type of rhythms in our body. So we can say that circadian clock or the circadian oscillator, it is a biochemical oscillator that cycles with a stable phase and is synchronized with the solar time. And what is solar time? So solar time in simple word means the rising and the setting of the sun. Such a clock in vivo period is necessarily almost exactly 24 hours. So circadian rhythms are usually of the 24 hours. The infraradians are of the ones that take longer than 24 hours, and the ultraradians are the one that takes less than 24 hours. So if we want to make a table of the same, So first we would be having the ultra radian, which takes less than 24 hours, that is they get completed in less than 24 hours. Then we have circadian rhythms that gets completed in exactly 24 hours, and then we have infraradian ones that gets completed in more than 24 hours. So the most common example of circadian rhythm is the rhythm that is followed in our body in the complete day. That is, we have a sleep cycle and a morning schedule. So this is what is included in the circadian rhythm. So depending upon what we have discussed, let us understand about, or let us try to solve this particular question. This question appears very difficult at the initial step, but as we have already studied about the type of the biological clocks, let us try to solve this question. So the question says that following are the plots representing the biological rhythms at different time points, depicted as SR represents sunrise, N represents noon, SS represents sunset, and MN represents the midnight. So these are the four graphs, or these are the four plots that are representing the biological rhythms. And in this question, we have to find out that which of the plots represents the ultra radian biological rhythms. So in order to solve this question, we need to understand that what is ultra radian rhythms. So as we have just discussed, that ultra radian rhythms are the one that usually takes less than 24 hours. And now, because we have understood about the basics of this topic, let us apply this in the question and solve it. So ultra radians must be getting completed in less than 24 hours. Let's analyze all the four plots. So in the first plot, let us mark the points that we would be taking into consideration. So let us assume, or let us have noon as our basal mark in all the four plots. So in the initial case, we can see that between two noons, that is between 12 hours, we have the cycle getting repeated many times. So it must be an example of ultra radian rhythms. Why? Because we have understood that ultra radian rhythms gets completed in less than 24 hours. Hence, first should be the option in which, so first should be the plot which represents the ultra radian rhythms. Let's move on to the second one. We can see that in the second one, there is no symmetry. So just eliminate the second option. In the third one, we can see that the cycle is getting repeated between two noons. Hence, third plot is also representing an ultra radian rhythm. Talking about the fourth one, taking into consideration our basal ones, so we can see that cycle is not getting completed in less than 12 hours. Hence, fourth is also not the correct option. So depending upon our analysis and our answer, we can find out that plot 1 and plot 3 are representing the ultra radian biological rhythms. And this is represented in option B. Hence, B is the correct option. So I hope this question is clear to you. This question is very easy, and you can easily fetch out 4 golden marks from this particular topic. So with this, we are done with the short topic of biological clocks in detail with the question discussed. So I hope this video was helpful for you. And if you like this video, please do like, share it with your friends, and please subscribe to my channel. And also, I'll be coming up very soon with these important topics in detail. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you soon. Bye.